Hey, John Simon from simpleprogrammer.com. And if you've been following my blog or following my videos, you probably know that I'm pretty passionate about automated testing, what I call black box automated testing or BAT testing. And in this video, I'm going to talk to you about why automated testing is really important. In fact, I think it's more important than unit testing, and talk about why you actually need to create a framework for doing this. So let's recap real quick here, just to make sure that you understand what black box automated testing or BAT testing is. So black box automated testing is the term I use for what's usually called automation testing or customer acceptance testing, automated customer acceptance testing, whatever you want to call it. But basically, for web applications or for any application, it's where you're testing the application programmatically through the same user interface that the user would use. So, you know, there's tools out there for doing this. Probably the most popular one for web development is called Selenium. And what this does, Selenium does, is it's actually a browser driver. It drives the browser. So it clicks on items inside the browser. It acts just like the user, but you can program it so that you can program the browser. You can program scripts to automatically click things, fill in things, check things, you know, just like a user would. Now, there's a huge value in this kind of testing. And the biggest value from this comes from the fact of, comes from your ability to leverage. So when you write a unit test, right, you write a lot of code to cover a small amount of production code. So there's a lot of unit test code, right? It's kind of reverse leverage. You have to, in general, you might write 2 to 3 times as much unit test code as you actually do production code to thoroughly test that production code or to run through that production code. The opposite is true with black box automated tests. You might write a very small amount of code to test a huge amount of the system. So you get a big surface area of testing. Now, the reason why I say this is so important is because, I don't know about you, but most organizations I've worked with or consulted for do not have very adequate test coverage. They mean to, even if they're doing unit testing, right, or even if they're doing test-driven development, but it just turns out that it doesn't quite work that way. So, you know, for those organizations, the best thing they could do is get more coverage. It's more important to get more coverage. That's the most important thing, is to cover more areas of the application than it is to be as thorough or low level as possible. So that's why for them, I say, hey, you know, yeah, unit testing is great. Do unit testing, keep doing that, that's fine. But it's more important to do this black box automated testing, because that's going to get you more coverage faster. So those tests are going to be more valuable to you at this point. Now, if you already had, you know, 100% unit test coverage or whatever, it's not going to be quite as valuable. I still think it's extremely valuable, don't get me wrong. So here's the thing, though. So if I've convinced you that you need to have black box automated tests, one of the big problems or one of the big arguments against them is that they're so difficult to maintain. This is a common scenario that happens when developers create automated tests or QA, right, is they create these tests, the UI changes a little bit, buttons change or workflow changes in the application. All of a sudden, hundreds or thousands of tests break. They all have to be manually updated and fixed. And everyone says, yeah, that's the problem with automation, is it costs us so much time. Well, the reason why that happens is because you have to treat your automation effort just like your production application. You need a framework. So this is where an automation framework comes into play. What an automation framework is it's basically, think of it as an application to test your application, right? So you're going to create a framework that's going to mirror your application, that's going to basically have all of the functionality of your application in there, and it's going to be an abstraction layer from something like Selenium. So you're going to write tests. The tests are going to use the framework, right? The framework has that abstraction layer, so it knows about your application. It knows about Selenium, right? The tests just define what needs to be done, and then that framework uses Selenium, and it automates your application. So now your tests become really simple. Your tests become actually plain English tests, maybe just a few lines of code. Most of the work is being done in the framework. Now, when something breaks or changes, let's say the UI changes, a button name changes, your tests still break. Don't get me wrong, but you fix it in one place in the framework. You say, oh, you know, the login button now has this ID. Now, those 50 tests that were using the login button, they all work because you just fix that one spot in the framework. So that's why it's really, really important to have an automation testing framework. I've actually created some courses on this. If you go to Pluralsight, you can search for Selenium, but you can also search for, or actually if you search for Selenium, you'll probably find I have a course on creating an automated testing framework with Selenium. And it kind of goes over the basics. I show you how to do that with WordPress. But I also do some consulting on this. So if your company is looking for someone, you know, I could write the automation framework for you. That's true. I do that. But the best way that I help a lot of people out is to show them how to do it or coach them how to do it and help them understand how to get this going. I've done this for a lot of different companies now, and I can really help you to get started. So just shoot me an email if you're interested in that. But, you know, I would definitely encourage you that you need to have automated tests, and you can make it easier on yourself if you're willing to invest a little bit in creating a framework. It's going to make it maintainable. It's going to make your tests easy to read and easy to maintain. And then it's going to make it so that QA and even business people, the way that I design frameworks, can actually write those tests and understand those tests. Well, hopefully this video has been helpful to you. If you wouldn't mind helping me out, subscribe to this channel if you like this video. You know, upvote it. Give me some comments if you have something to say about this and share this video to your friends. Thanks a lot for watching, and I will talk to you again next week. Take care.